Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome back for another exciting edition of VWF Nitro, the CAW show that is changing Monday nights. Hello, everyone. Welcome to the sold-out VWF Arena. I am Isaac, a.k.a. Omega, as always, here to call the action. And ladies and gentlemen, we are diving right in to the opening contest of the night. It is a tag team contest. And there you see Ashlee and Jessica, the Simpson sisters. And ladies and gentlemen, of course, as you all know, as you remember last week, Ashlee Simpson took on this woman about to make her entrance, Lara Croft, and was defeated in singles action. Well, ladies and gentlemen, even though Lara Croft is a very capable athlete and it was a huge victory, ladies and gentlemen, Ashlee Simpson argued to the press that she was humiliated by her defeat to Lara Croft, feeling that Lara is an inferior athlete. And so, as a small measure of revenge, Ashlee got together with her sister Jessica and laid down the challenge to Lara Croft. Lara could pick a partner of her choosing to take on the former NGW Women's Tag Team Champions. And well, ladies and gentlemen, what a tag team partner to pick. Ladies and gentlemen, here she comes. We haven't seen her in several weeks, but it's the former EWE Siren Champion. I am talking, of course, about the woman who made her big return at the third annual Rose Knight Diva Invitational in the mixed tag match along with Chris Knight against the Cobra Elite. I am talking about X-23. And listen to these fans on their feet for the Mutant Superstar. And she will be Lara Croft's tag team partner tonight against the Simpson sisters to start off this important edition of VWF Nitro. Ladies and gentlemen, of course, to get this out of the way, ladies and gentlemen, you can always, of course, follow us on Facebook and Twitter. You can see all of the information at the bottom of your screen. We will be flashing it if we haven't already flashed it, ladies and gentlemen. My monitor didn't show it, but perhaps we've already shown it. Either way, you can look us up on Facebook, Twitter, you name it. VWF is the league that is in touch with you. All right, Lara Croft starting off the action with Jessica Simpson and a nice hurricane runner there from Lara Croft, the Tomb Raider. And ladies and gentlemen, what a tag team partner she's picked. X-23 is not afraid of anyone in that squared circle. She will take the fight to the Simpson sisters. Jessica now with Lara Croft, fires her into the turnbuckle, into a neutral corner. Big right hand. Like I said, ladies and gentlemen, Ashlee Simpson told anyone who would listen that she felt that she was humiliated last week, losing to an inferior opponent in Lara Croft. But ladies and gentlemen, Lara beat her fair and square, but this is just some bad blood here. And ladies and gentlemen, as it stands, it's a great match to open up tonight's edition of Nitro. Ladies and gentlemen, just quickly running down the card. We have Rei Hino taking on Usagi Sakaino, a match that was set up reflecting the events of last week. And ladies and gentlemen, we also have in singles competition one half of the new VWF Tag Team Champions. I'm talking, of course, about Dixie Clements. She's taking on Michiru. And ladies and gentlemen, who knows how many more surprises await us in this installment of Nitro. Ladies and gentlemen, of course, we are inching slowly but surely toward the second click preview event here in the Vixens Wrestling Federation. I am talking, of course, about War Games. It's coming to you in a few short weeks. Ashlee now with Lara, Irish Whip, leapfrog there from Ashlee. Ashlee, a former NGW Women's Champion. Lara Croft, of course, was the only female in no DQ CAW history to compete in the league. And right now, Lara's in a lot of trouble. She's gone the distance so far, which is not such a good thing in a tag team bout. X-23 is still waiting in her corner, waiting patiently to be tagged in by her partner, Lara Croft. Jessica fired into that turnbuckle. And now X23 tagged in. Double team maneuver coming up. Irish whip. Drop toe hold from Lara. Nice elbow from X23. And so far, ladies and gentlemen, even though they've only been a tag team for a very short time, Lara and X23 showing some chemistry here. And, of course, Ashlee makes the save right there. Into an armbar on Jessica. Nice Northern Lights suplex there from the former EWE Siren champion. Most of you YouTube viewers out there, ladies and gentlemen, will remember X23 from her famous brutal match at CAW Destiny 4. Oh my, against Kasumi Todo. Jessica now going into another armbar here on X23. Gonna take a lot more than that to slow X23 down. Jessica, oh my, nice go behind from X23, a shot to the small of the back. X23 fires Jessica back into the turnbuckle. Oh my, nice spear. Jessica in a compromised position and a nice drop kick from X23 to follow. X23 still with the advantage. No, Irish whip countered. Nice counter into a side effect from Jessica Simpson. The lateral press, oh my. Jessica's got the ropes and Lara makes the save. And right now, that really rubbed Jessica the wrong way. Jessica has lost her focus here. Lara's not the legal woman. And, well, Jessica learns that the hard way. X23 with control. Shining Wizard. Beautifully executed Shining Wizard onto the head of Jessica Simpson. And Ashlee can do nothing but watch on the far side of your screen. These two women jockeying back and forth. Jessica just missed with a big windmill right. And X23 nails the bicycle kick. Lateral press doesn't hook a leg. Two. And Ashlee once again comes in to pull X23 off. Jessica Simpson trying to get the advantage back. Firing X23 into the wrong part of town. But there's no Ashlee for a double team maneuver. But a nice tornado DDT there from Jessica Simpson. Of course, as I mentioned earlier, ladies and gentlemen, the Simpson sisters, former NGW Women's Tag Team Champions. And just recently, ladies and gentlemen, at Retribution, they got to wrestle for the VWF Tag Team titles, but came up short against the then champions, Team G4. And of course, now, ladies and gentlemen, the current reigning and defending Tag Team Champions, our Tequila Sunrise, still undefeated here in the Vixens Wrestling Federation. And ladies and gentlemen, believe it or not, this match is sure to have ramifications in the tag team division. You know that Dixie Clements and Reiko Hinamoto have to be on notice. The victories in the tag title division mean so much when there are new champions, because it is literally anybody's game. As you see a nice top rope arm drag from Ashlee, that could do it. One and only a one. A lot of saves having to be made in this match. X23 getting up, seemingly no worse for wear. And again, this time it's Ashlee losing her focus. Oh my, but a nice elbow to X23 into another side effect. This time it was Ashley's turn, not to be outdone by her sister. Ashlee picking up X23. Ashley's got her set up. Oh my, nice takedown into the Simpson lock. This could do it. This could do it for the Simpson sisters, but a nice leg drop from Lara Croft just in the nick of time. Boy, you talk about X23 getting saved at the last second. Nice awareness there from Lara Croft to see her partner was in trouble, and now X23 back on the offensive with that nice rebound suplex. X23, a very physical wrestler. In your face, and oh my, devastating maneuver there, dropping Ashlee onto her knee. That'll knock the wind out of you in a hurry. But Ashlee, right back up. If she's hurt from that last move, she's not showing no ill effects from it. Another double team maneuver here coming up. The Simpson sisters keeping the tags frequent. Nice kick off of the ropes as Ashlee held X23 in place. A couple of right hands from Jessica Simpson and a nice kick. A nice roundhouse there sends X23 sprawling to the mat. X23's been in a lot of trouble. She's been in there for the last 5 minutes or so. Now it's her that needs to tag to Lara Croft. And once again, the Simpson sisters showing that experience, cutting the ring in half. X-23 is in the wrong part of town. She's in a lot of trouble right now. And Ashlee and Jessica Simpson just going to work on the former EWE Siren champion. The Simpson sisters can win this one at any moment, ladies and gentlemen. They can pretty much end this one at will. Lara Croft can only watch. Ashlee, nice DDT onto X-23. X-23 in a lot of trouble. Ashlee on the top, gonna try the lip sync assault! Missed! X-23 dove out of the way at the last second. Jessica clears out Lara, not knowing that Ashlee missed. Ashlee needs her partner right now, and Jessica's distracted. But there she comes, right back into that corner. Saw that her sister was starting to get in a little bit of trouble. And Jessica Simpson wisely goes back into the corner. Oh my, X-23 got taken down, but X-23 kips up, nails the clothesline. X-23 using that healing factor to find her second win. Oh, what a hard shove into the turnbuckle. Did you see the way that Ashlee Simpson violently fell off of those ropes? And oh my, nice sit-down powerbomb. X-23 has completely turned the tables. And look at this. Military press into that sickening gut breaker there. And X-23 makes the much-needed tag. In comes a very fresh and very fired up Lara Croft. Lara with Ashlee off the ropes. Beautiful crossbody. Lara takes out Jessica. Does so again. Bulldog from Lara Croft. And the Tomb Raider with control. Lateral press. One, two. Was that two or was that three? No, the referee signaling that Jessica just barely got in there. That had to be 2 3/4, ladies and gentlemen, easily. Victory roll, what a counter. But once again, Jessica right there to make the save. Come on, referee. And now a little bit of 2-on-1 here. Lara cleared out Jessica, but it's Ashlee who's the legal woman. But Lara, with eyes in the back of her head, takes it to Ashlee. Ashlee right back in trouble. And a Randy Orton-style backbreaker there. And Lara Croft signaling for something. She could be looking for that Tomb Raider, that modified Emerald Fusion. But wait a minute, look at this. Yes, there it was. There was the Tomb Raider. X-23 clears out Jessica. This is it. One, two, three, she got her. And Lara Croft has pinned Ashlee Simpson for the second week in a row. X-23 and Lara Croft have scored a huge upset over the former NGW Women's Tag Team Champions. What a victory for the new tag team of Lara and X-23. You see the replays here. It was back and forth. But ladies and gentlemen, a lot of frequent saves on the part of the Simpson sisters extended the match, but it was only a matter of time. Lara Croft hit the Tomb Raider. X-23 finally cleared out Jessica, and there was no save to be made. 1, 2, and a 3. And Lara Croft and X-23 are successful in their first bout as a tag team. And ladies and gentlemen, could you be looking at future number one contenders? Ladies and gentlemen, I'm sure Tequila Sunrise would love a chance to defend their titles against this awesome new tag team. What does the future hold for X-23 and Lara Croft? Ladies and gentlemen, we will find out. Ladies and gentlemen, we're going to take you to the back. We will be back in just a moment. Wow, it looks like we have some dissension, maybe, in the ranks of Al-Qaeda. But, ladies and gentlemen, I understand our cameras now are taking you to another part of the backstage area, back to the dressing room, where it appears that Renoa Hartilly has jumped the hardcore champion, Lufisto. And Lufisto's in a lot of trouble here. Of course, ladies and gentlemen, it is my weekly duty to remind you that the VWF hardcore title is... Oh, my, as you see a nice DDT from Lufisto. The VWF hardcore title, of course, is contested under 24/7 rules. But so far, ladies and gentlemen, Lufisto has become the first woman to ever successfully defend the hardcore title. As you see her powerbomb Renoa into those wooden lockers. Oh, my. And I think maybe Renoa Hartilly has bit off a little more than she can chew. Lufisto was ready. Oh, my, another Van Terminator. And ladies and gentlemen, this is the kind of stuff that Lufisto enjoys. These women of the Vixens Wrestling Federation have to remember that. Any time that they decide they want to try their luck with Lufisto, they are working right into the champion's hands. And ladies and gentlemen, earlier in the night, we saw Lufisto talking to Aerith Gainsborough. And ladies and gentlemen, one can only wonder what that means. But as it stands, Lufisto looking like she was more than ready for the challenge of Renoa Hartilly. And look at this. Oh my, Lufisto powerbombs her into those wooden cubby holes again. Lufisto. What's she going to do here? Oh my, just slamming Renoa's skull into that weight bench. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm being told by the production truck that it was Renoa who came in here and jumped Lufisto. Lufisto did not go looking for Renoa. Renoa. Oh my, throws Lufisto into that 42-inch high-definition television presented by Vizio. And ladies and gentlemen, that's not going to make our sponsors happy. Oh my, now throwing Lufisto into that giant metal case and just slamming her head against it. I mean, who leaves all of these weapons just sitting around in the dressing room? It's got to be an occupational hazard. These two just trading blows back and forth. Nothing anyone can do to stop this. It goes on until one woman is unable to continue. And Renoa's in a lot of trouble. Renoa trying to sneak up on Lufisto and steal the hardcore title, but so far unsuccessful. Inverted atomic drop. And Renoa, nice elbow. Renoa, interestingly enough, not going for a weapon right now. Oh, Lufisto comes back with a running knee lift. The super hardcore anime picks Renoa up and just drops her. Renoa is unconscious, or almost unconscious, dropped right onto that metal trash can. And Lufisto right now just stopping to pause and enjoy her work here. I'm telling you, ladies and gentlemen, Lufisto enjoys this. You're not putting Lufisto in any kind of dangerous situation. You're playing right into her hands. German suplex. Ladies and gentlemen, when you're a VWF vixen and you attack Lufisto, you're doing just what she wants you to do. You're letting her have fun. And now Lufisto going to put the finishing touches on it. Oh, my, and that Van Terminator is just the exclamation point because, ladies and gentlemen, Lufisto, for the second time, has retained. And now, ladies and gentlemen, moving on to our next contest. This one was made last week, and, ladies and gentlemen, the Senshi explode once more as Rei Hino takes on Usagi Sakaino. Ladies and gentlemen, you remember what happened last week. Rei Hino in Usagi's corner for her match with Makoto Kaino. But Makoto took both women out on her way to victory and retaining the Queen of the Mountain briefcase. And ladies and gentlemen, after that, Rei Hino and Usagi Sakaino just absolutely got into a brawl. And ladies and gentlemen, that's when Frederick James Francis made this match happen. And now, ladies and gentlemen, once again, we are going to see Senshi versus Senshi as that woman right there, Usagi Sakaino, better known as Sailor Moon, takes on her former friend and her current enemy, Rei Hino, better known as Sailor Mars. And ladies and gentlemen, at this point, I think wherever she is, Minako Aino may be just glad that she's staying out of all of this Senshi business. Because, of course, ladies and gentlemen, you have to remember Makoto Kaino, Usagi Sakaino, and Rei Hino all kind of in a three-way feud with one another. Then, of course, you've got the outer Senshi, Haruka Michiru, feuding with Tequila Sunrise. And, ladies and gentlemen, Ami Mizuno is on the shelf right now, thanks to Al-Qaeda. So, ladies and gentlemen, I just wonder if wherever she is, Minako Aino is enjoying her role as a pacifist. Because, ladies and gentlemen, right now in the Vixens Wrestling Federation, it is not an easy thing to be a Senshi member. And there you see Rei Hino making her way to the ring. Ladies and gentlemen, a lot of bad blood here. You remember, of course, Rei Hino was in Usagi's corner last week, but Makoto took both of them out. And ladies and gentlemen, that was just a horrible brawl between the two former friends that erupted after the match. Both of them losing their cool. And right now, ladies and gentlemen, they're both just looking to take out a little bit of frustration on one another. Remember, ladies and gentlemen, that both of these women were a part of the Queen of the Mountain match at Retribution, in which Makoto Kaino came away with the briefcase. And that's where all of this Senshi business has started. And right now, these two going back and forth. Nice Hurricane Rana from Rei Hino. Who can forget, ladies and gentlemen, when Usagi Sakaino made her VWF debut, she wrestled literally on 5 minutes' notice. Rei Hino now, so far with control. A nice kick to the face of Usagi. Nice DDT there from Rei. Rei making the early cover, one, and only a one. Rei with control over Usagi. Usagi with a knee to the midsection, but into, oh my, a takedown there from Rei Hino. And Usagi right back in trouble. But a nice elbow to the back of Ray's head. Irish whip, tilt-a-whirl backbreaker connects for Usagi Sakaino. Ladies and gentlemen, you will have to forgive me for my voice. Ladies and gentlemen, sinuses are taking their toll on me. It is the change of season. And ladies and gentlemen, isn't it hard to believe that for those of you, my fellow Americans, that we're headed toward Thanksgiving and Christmas? Truly amazing, ladies and gentlemen. The year just flies by. Hard to believe we are already over 2 months into the existence of the Vixens Wrestling Federation. And ladies and gentlemen, what a last 2 months it's been. Ladies and gentlemen, the VWF action is nonstop. And ladies and gentlemen, it is thrilling and exciting. You can't miss a second's action here in the VWF. Ladies and gentlemen, it has been my honor and privilege to be the commentator for this upstart league. And ladies and gentlemen, I look to commentate this league for as long as Frederick James Francis will allow me, because it has been one of the pleasures of my commentating career. Rei Hino has kept control of this match. Lateral press, hooks the leg, two, and only a two. Rei Hino, though, staying on the offensive. Usagi's been in trouble since the bell rang. And another DDT there from Sailor Mars. Rei Hino, of course, looking to hit that patented, of course, rolling mandala. Usagi Sakaino, on the other hand, looking to hit her trademark moonclash, the move that won her the NGW Women's Championship several years ago. And Usagi now with her first really major offensive flurry of the match. And now she's taking control. Rei Hino in the corner. Nice flip right there. Shades of Tiger Mask. Usagi counters with a Hurricane Rana. Hooks the legs. One, two, no. Oh, my. I thought that could have been it. Usagi trying to make the comeback. So much bad blood between these two women, as well as Makoto Kaino, also known as Sailor Jupiter. Like I said, it's kind of an unenviable position to be a senshi right now in the Vixens Wrestling Federation. Usagi perched on the top rope, measures Rei, leaps, and scores with that unorthodox knee drop. It connected, what a beauty. Now, Usagi on the other side. Hits the crossbody, shades of Ricky Steamboat. And Usagi really feeling it right now. And going to go back to that Hurricane Rana. And you can see why. Standing moonsault. Usagi hooks the ropes. Uncharacteristic of her, I might add. But Rei kicks out. And ladies and gentlemen, that just goes to show you how down and dirty this rivalry has gotten. All of these senshi, who were the examples, of great sportsmanship and of heroism. Ladies and gentlemen, they have all been reduced to resorting to dirty, underhanded tactics like that just in the name of pride and bragging rights. And what an athletic move there by Rei Hino. That nice arm drag. Oh, my. Measured her and nailed the... That was about a 20-yard field goal. Lion Saw connects. And just like that, Rei Hino back in control. And a nice 450 splash right there. Rei back on top. Rei nailed... No, missed with the frog splash. Oh, my. Rei went to the well one too many times, and it cost her. Now Usagi coming back with some devastating strikes, ending it with a spinning heel kick. And now... More strikes. Look at Usagi just punish Rei Hino. Oh, my. Into another head scissors takedown. Usagi utilizes those head scissors perfectly. Usagi leaps with the moonsault. Got it. And that could do it. But no. Usagi now signaling for something else. Getting visibly fired up, trying to fire herself up. Daring Rei to get back up. Rei does just that. She's right back in trouble. And she got nailed with a drop kick. Now Usagi back up on top yet again. And this time wisely decides not to leap. Rei doesn't know where she's at. Oh my, but she found out where she was at. And look at this. High risk maneuver missed. The action is fast and furious here between the two former best friends. Rei Hino fired into the buckle. Another Tiger Mask flip from Usagi Sakaino. Usagi powers out of that headlock. And there it is. There it is. Moon Clash. Got it. But Rei's right back up. I don't believe it. How did Rei Hino get right back up? And look at this. Rolling mandala. And Usagi is not kipping up. One, two, no. I don't believe it, ladies and gentlemen. First, Rei Hino no sells the moon clash. Then Usagi kicks out of the rolling mandala. But she won't kick out of that. The frog splash connects. Rei Hino limps over to Usagi, but doesn't make the cover. Rei nails the DDT. Both of these women seem to have lost confidence when they hit their respective finishers and couldn't put the opponent away. But now it's Rei still in charge. And I think Rei's looking to hit it again. Rei's got Usagi right where she wants her. And yes, here it comes. 619. into that splash. The Fire Kenrana, 2-0. And Usagi now is back on the offensive. Where are they getting this? Ladies and gentlemen, what a back and forth contest. And you will only see action this intense on Nitro. Rei going for that Fire Kenrana. And she nailed it. 1-2. Yes. Yes, just barely. Usagi kicked out a split second after the ref counted three. And Rei Hino, a.k.a. Sailor Mars, has defeated her former best friend and now her bitter rival, Usagi Sakaino, a.k.a. Sailor Moon. And once again, the Senshi explode. And once again, it's Usagi coming up on the short end. And Rei Hino has gained in what in her eyes will be a shade of revenge. But wait, wait, no, these two continue to brawl. But wait, here's Makoto Kaino. And she's taking out both of them. Makoto comes in with a chair and takes out Rei and Usagi. Oh my, let's take you to the back. Looks like Al Qaeda is coming up to Frederick James Francis. Oh my, sounds good to me, Frederick. Oh my. A killer main event. Al Qaeda taking on the VWF champion Aerith and the hardcore champion Luke Vista. Oh my, and ladies and gentlemen, that's coming up after our next contest. Ladies and gentlemen, what a big match this is going to be in singles action. One half of Tequila Sunrise, the new tag team champions, takes on Michiru. And ladies and gentlemen, you remember last week, even though Tequila Sunrise cleanly and decisively beat Haruka and Michiru for the second time at Retribution, this time for number one contendership, Haruka and Michiru are still refusing to move on. And so they, I mean, just in a cowardly display, attacked Tequila Sunrise right after Tequila Sunrise had claimed the tag team titles. Ruined their greatest moment. And now, ladies and gentlemen, Tequila Sunrise looking for a little bit of revenge here in singles action. And here you see Michiru suspiciously without Haruka. Where is Haruka? I have a feeling she won't stay hidden in the back for long. And ladies and gentlemen, Tequila Sunrise now has defeated Michiru and Haruka twice in a row. And pretty easily, I might add. Tequila Sunrise has never really struggled with Haruka and Michiru, but of course the Outer Senshi won't let it go. They just refuse to move on. I mean, they are just obsessed with trying to beat Tequila Sunrise. And thus far, they haven't been able to do it. And now, ladies and gentlemen, listen to this crowd. 20,000 plus on their feet for one half of the new tag team champions. They are on their feet. For the big Texan, they are on their feet, of course, for the three-count cowgirl, Dixie Clements. She, along with her longtime partner and friend, the Zero Fighter Reiko Hinamoto, went on not only to remain undefeated in tag team competition here in the Vixens Wrestling Federation, the only undefeated tag team left, but ladies and gentlemen, they finally claimed what they felt was rightfully theirs and what a lot of people felt was rightfully theirs. The VWF Tag Team titles when they defeated Team G4, Morgan Webb, and Olivia Mine. And ladies and gentlemen, what tag team champions Dixie and Reiko will be. But ladies and gentlemen, that's not on the line tonight. Right now, it's just about restoring some pride. It's singles competition. It's Michiru. It's Dixie. And it's right now. And ladies and gentlemen, of course, don't forget, immediately following the conclusion of this match, it will be main event time as all three members of Al-Qaeda, Tifa Lockhart, Abdullah Bin Laden, and Lindsay take on the team of the VWF champion, Aerith Gainsborough, and her partner, the hardcore champion, Lou Fisto. Ladies and gentlemen, it's a main event you do not want to miss. And right now, Michiru started out with the advantage. Michiru and Haruka as a team, kind of known for starting off fast against Tequila Sunrise, but in both occasions they faltered down the stretch. And a nice hurricane run to take down there from Michiru. On to Dixie. Dixie from Texas. And ladies and gentlemen, she embodies the Texas spirit, and that's what's helped to carry her on to being one half of the tag team champions. Oh my, Dixie right there just punching away at the exposed head of Michiru. Ladies and gentlemen, you know that this has got to feel pretty good for Dixie. It's got to be good for Dixie to get her hands on this woman who makes up one half of the team that just will not let this rivalry go. Oh my, two count there. I just don't get why Haruka and Michiru are so obsessed with continuing to stalk the new tag team champions. I mean, they've lost fair and square twice. Nice clothesline and bulldog combination from the three-count cowgirl. But Michiru's right back up. Caught an elbow tie-up. Nice headlock there from Dixie. Elbow. Trying to follow it up. No, go behind from Michiru. Michiru with Dixie face first into the buckle. Haruka, excuse me, Michiru setting her up. Could we get a super backdrop maybe from the top? Yes. Oh my, high impact move there. That could be it. One, two, no. Referee only signaling two. Michiru throws Dixie back into another turnbuckle. Drop kick. And now what? No, Dixie shoves her way out of the corner into a DDT. Dixie stomping away. And a nice elbow there from the big Texan. Now Dixie uncharacteristically going to the top rope. Leaps and misses. Oh, she telegraphed that one. And now Michiru right back on the offensive. And a nice elbow now from Michiru. Trying to show Dixie that anything you can do, I can do better. Michiru Kaio with control on Dixie Clements. No, Dixie counters with a throw into the turnbuckle, but a nice bookend counter from Michiru. Into a lion salt off the second rope. Could we get another intense match like we just saw between Usagi Tsukino and Rei Hino? A nice bulldog from Michiru. And now Michiru really starting to feel it. She's signaling for the deep submerge. And she got it. The deep submerge hooks both legs. One. Two, No! Dixie kicks out of the deep submerge. Now what can Michiru do? That was her best move. Dixie, Irish whip, oh my. What force, what strength from Dixie. Over the ropes, 360 went Michiru. Dixie not giving her any room to breathe. And now looking to drop her over that steel guardrail. Oh my, face first. Dixie's out for blood. She's content to just punish Michiru. Trying to send a message to Haruka along the way. And she just continues to drop her on that barricade. No. Michiru gets out of it. Now Dixie could be taking the ride. Oh, no. Oh, my. And into another head scissors. Referee with a 20 count to work with. Oh, Dixie takes the ride on the steel steps. Dixie, adrenaline, I think, motivated her to try and punish Michiru on the guardrail, but now Michiru kind of at home on the outside. And now Michiru back out to break the count, maybe. She measures Dixie from the apron. But, oh my, almost took too much time. Acai moonsault into a bulldog. What an amazing athletic move from Michiru Kaio. And Dixie is right back in trouble. And ladies and gentlemen, it's amazing how a match can swing so fast. And oh no. No, not this. Please not this. Michiru, perhaps aiming to use that table. But no, Dixie trying to fight her way away from it. Good for Dixie to try and do that. Oh my! Michiru just got powerbombed through about 1 inch of padding on top of a concrete surface. And now, what's good for the goose is good for the gander, Michiru. And Dixie may be setting Michiru up to take the ride. Dixie on the top. Oh my God, she's not gonna do this. Leaping and missed. Oh my God. Dixie's gotta be out. Front suplex. Oh my. I think the referee could count to 50 and Dixie wouldn't get back in. And Michiru knows that and fires Dixie in. She wants to pin the three count cowgirl. And right now, ladies and gentlemen, if she makes the cover, I would not put my money on Dixie kicking out. Dixie's out on her feet. Michiru trying to go in for the kill. Michiru easily counters that grapple into another bulldog off the corner. And Michiru now signaling again for the deep submerge, and ladies and gentlemen, this is going to be it. This is going to be it. She's going to put Dixie away right here. Too much damage has been done to Dixie Clements. No, she's going with the Shining Wizard. Gets a full head of steam and turns the lights out. And that'll do it. What? No. Dixie, back up. I think she just angered her. Now Dixie's mad. Dixie back up with a move we know so well. The Dixie Cutter. That helped win them the tag titles. The cover. One, two, no. I don't know if I've seen anyone kick out of the Dixie Cutter yet. Unreal. Victory roll. One. Countered. One. Two, got her! Dixie Clements counters the victory roll and defeats Michiru. What a match. What a match. I don't believe it, ladies and gentlemen. Michiru hit the Shining Wizard. It should have been over, But Dixie kips up. Unbelievably comes back, hits the Dixie Cutter. And check this out, ladies and gentlemen. In just a moment, after Michiru kicked out of the Dixie Cutter, check this out. Victory roll, countered by Dixie. Two, and yes, a three, she got her. Shades of the Bret Hart-Owen Hart match at WrestleMania 10. Dixie's not, no, oh no! I knew this was coming. I don't like to ever be right, ladies and gentlemen, when it comes to something like that. But now, a cowardly attack from Haruka. I don't believe it. Well, there you see the hardcore champion and the VWF champion getting ready to team up because they've got a handicap match coming up tonight on the main event of Nitro. Aerith Gainsborough and Lufisto team up to take on the three-woman team of Al-Qaeda, Wincy, Tifa Lockhart, and Abdallah Bin Laden. Ladies and gentlemen, what an explosive main event this is going to be. And of course, you see last week, Aerith came out to call out Tifa, but Tifa was already waiting for her. Attacked her like a thief in the night. And Lufisto tried to come down and do the right thing. But for her trouble, she was met out on the ramp by Tifa. And Tifa, oh my, you may not want to look at this again. Power bombed her off of the stage. Ladies and gentlemen, how Lufisto's career didn't end, I don't know. And of course, that was when Tifa made it official, when she became the third member of Al-Qaeda. But now, ladies and gentlemen, listen to these fans. It's hard to hear myself talk, because here comes the only champion VWF has ever known. I am talking, of course, about Aerith Gainsborough, and what a champion she has been. She's taken on all comers, not only on television, but at every VWF live event, you can always count on Aerith defending her VWF championship. What a fighting champion. And ladies and gentlemen, she overcame her longtime rival Lindsay at Retribution. But of course, ladies and gentlemen, Al-Qaeda not done with her, because it was Tifa Lockhart who betrayed her best friend Ami Mizuno. And now it's Tifa who is after Aerith. And here comes Lufisto. We've already seen her tonight. She retained the hardcore title against Renoa Hartilli. And then, of course, this match was made. And now, after last week, ladies and gentlemen, after Lufisto miraculously has come back after being powerbombed off the stage by Tifa, ladies and gentlemen, she is out for revenge against Al-Qaeda. Aerith Gainsborough gained a huge ally when Lufisto came down and tried to help her. And Lufisto looks once again to try and help her friend Aerith tonight. And of course, ladies and gentlemen, the team of Lufisto and Aerith will be taking on Al-Qaeda. All three of them. Yes, ladies and gentlemen, this is a 3-on-2 handicap match. And there you see all three members of Al-Qaeda. Lindsay, Tifa Lockhart, and of course, their mentor, the controversial Abdallah Bin Laden. Ladies and gentlemen, the CAW world is still in shock after what Tifa Lockhart did at Retribution, when it was discovered that she attacked and turned on her longtime best friend Ami Mizuno. Then she attacked Aerith. Then she did it again last week. Ladies and gentlemen, Al-Qaeda is dangerous. And ladies and gentlemen, they are not afraid to take the low road. Lufisto and Aerith are going to have their hands full tonight, because Al-Qaeda, their motto is win at all costs. And it should be win if you can, lose if you must, but always cheat. Bell's gone, we are underway. This is your main event of this week's edition of Nitro. VWF champion Aerith Gainsborough teams with hardcore champion Lufisto to take on all three members of Al-Qaeda in a tag team handicap match. And the two longtime rivals started off Lindsay and Aerith. Lindsay with Aerith. Oh my, went for a backbreaker but walked right into a beautiful hurricane runner from the champ. And ladies and gentlemen, you hear 20,000 plus on their feet for the People's Champion. I mean, ladies and gentlemen, you never hear of someone speaking an ill word about Aerith. Just a class act all around. And what a great representative for the Vixens Wrestling Federation as their champion. But ladies and gentlemen, she has had her enemies. And ladies and gentlemen, these three women that she is taking on are a perfect example of that. Aerith, of course, represents everything that Al-Qaeda is against. Aerith, a class act, a competitor, an all-around good person. Al-Qaeda, of course, not here to make friends, and they will try anything that they can, take any shortcut they can to win a match and to walk away with the VWF title. Aerith is truly a marked woman. Oh, my, and she's in a really bad part of town right now. Double team maneuver coming up. Lindsay tags in Abdallah. Drop toe hold, elbow, got it. That move has worked so well for all three members of Al-Qaeda, no matter which two it has been in the past teaming up. And Aerith Gainsborough in a lot of trouble. And you can see a troubled look on the face of the hardcore champion, Lufisto, in the corner. Nice counter from Aerith. On to Abdallah. And Aerith makes the much-needed tag. Here comes the super hardcore anime. The hardcore champion, Lufisto. Oh, my, but walks right into a headlock from Abdallah. And Abdallah, a clubbing blow. Abdallah, oh, my, with a bow and arrow over the rope, contorting Lufisto's arms in a direction they were not intended to go. Lufisto off the ropes and into the buckle. Another double team coming up. Irish whip. And a devastating punch there from both Lindsay and Abdallah. And now Lindsay, the legal woman again. Tifa Lockhart waiting for her first opportunity to be tagged in. But ladies and gentlemen, knowing what Tifa has become, I'm sure, ladies and gentlemen, that she's in no hurry to get in there. Lateral press. And only a one before Aerith makes the save. And Lufisto comes back with a running knee lift. And now going to work on the legs of Lindsay. Oh my, but come on. Come on. This is ridiculous. Tifa holding Lufisto as Lindsay nails a knee. And now, oh my, that modified fisherman suplex from the former NGW Women's Champion. Lindsay now with all sorts of control on Lufisto. Now a double team maneuver. Rocket launcher. Tifa connects. And Al-Qaeda has cut the ring in half. And now Tifa, oh no, measuring Lufisto for some sweet chin music. And she missed. Lufisto ducked under and a nice knee drop there. Oh my. If Lufisto had not ducked underneath that super kick, it would have been lights out. Northern Lights suplex. Nice bridge. One. And only a one. Gonna have to do a little more than that to keep the two other members from Al-Qaeda interfering. Ladies and gentlemen, I don't know what Aerith and Lufisto are going to do. If they pin one of the members of Al-Qaeda, you're still talking about the inactive woman on the two-woman team trying to take on the two inactive women on Al-Qaeda. I mean, it's a mismatch in every sense of the word, ladies and gentlemen. But, of course, Aerith and Lufisto wanting to get their hands on Al-Qaeda were more than willing to wrestle this match on Al-Qaeda's terms. And Tifa Lockhart, the traitor, going to work on Lufisto. Remember, it was Tifa who was the one who powerbombed Lufisto off of the stage last week. Ladies and gentlemen, I don't know how Lufisto wasn't paralyzed. I mean, that should have been a career-ending injury. I mean, I know Lufisto's been through a lot in the indie leagues, She's not afraid to get down and dirty, but ladies and gentlemen, that was sick last week. Oh, no. Tifa going for the final heaven, but once again, Lufisto gets out of it. Lufisto has had great ring presence so far. First, she ducked underneath a super kick, and now she just got out of the final heaven. Tifa fired into the buckle. Lufisto making a much-needed tag. Double-team maneuver coming up. Oh, my. And just shoving Tifa upside down into the turnbuckle at about 50 miles an hour. Nice elbow from the champion. Well, I guess they're both champions. I am, of course, talking about the VWF champion, Aerith. And now, Lufisto giving him a taste of her own medicine. Nice headbutt from the VWF champion, Aerith Gainsborough, into a chin breaker. Aerith and Lufisto with control. One, two. And Tifa kicked out on her own, even though Lufisto was able to hold Abdallah and Lindsay at bay. Oh, my. Aerith tried to press the advantage, but here comes Tifa. Tifa nailing some lefts, some rights. Go behind. Now she's got Aerith firing her into the turnbuckle, giving chase. Nice clothesline. Nice clothesline from another former NGW Women's Champion. You're talking about so many decorated women in that ring right now. Former NGW Women's Champions, Aerith Gainsborough, Tifa Lockhart, and Lindsay. The reigning and defending VWF champion, Aerith. The reigning and defending hardcore champion, Lufisto. Ladies and gentlemen, for all intents and purposes, and I'm sure it's burning her up, the only woman in this match who has never tasted gold is Abdallah bin Laden. The self-professed mentor and teacher of Tifa and Lindsay. But ladies and gentlemen, maybe it should be the reverse. Maybe Abdallah could learn a thing or two from Tifa and Lindsay. Tifa now still with control over Aerith. Inverted atomic drop, nailed her right on the butt. A second one. Throwing Aerith into that opposing turnbuckle. Now it's Lindsay being tagged in, and another double team maneuver. Oh no, Lindsay hooking the ropes. Come on. Two, and Aerith kicks out. Good for her. Oh, but right into a drop toe hold. Elbow drop from Lindsay. Lindsay now with another arm bar. Irish whip, VWF champion off the ropes, but counters it into a Hurricane Rana. And making the tag, yes. Back in comes a fresh Lufisto. Oh my, but walked right into a headlock and a big right hand and a flying tackle from Lindsay. Lindsay with a staggered Lufisto. Suplex City coming up. No, a thumb to the eye from Lufisto into a nice, oh my, enziguri right there. But Lindsay right back up. Another flying tackle connects. Ladies and gentlemen, Tifa Lockhart's not been involved with this match much at all, and neither has Abdallah. Lindsay's done most of the wrestling for Al-Qaeda, and here it comes, the five knuckle shuffle. Lufisto scrambling back up to her feet, but still in trouble, needing something good to happen. And there's the hot tag. Aerith back in. Down goes Lindsay. Down goes Abdallah. Tifa's already been cleared out. And look at this. Aerith has Lindsay right where she wants her. The great gospel. Lindsay was planted right on her head. This is it. One, two. Yes, she got her. She got her. You gotta be kidding me. Ladies and gentlemen, I know as well as I did, you saw the referee's hand come down for the three. It's over. It should be over. And I think Aerith thought it was over. Oh, my. There'll be a lot of reviewing of this tape in front of the VWF committee, ladies and gentlemen, it was over. But I think Lufisto got the message quickly, asked for a tag from Aerith. Now Lufisto back on the offensive. This match should not still be going on, in this commentator's opinion. Lindsay off the ropes, Lufisto with the go behind, but an armbar counter from Lindsay. Lufisto thrown into the buckle. Oh my, and a big shoulder charge right there. And Lindsay right now really enjoying herself. And it's just a question of who she would prefer to tag. Abdallah instructed her to tag in Tifa. Now it's Tifa and Lufisto. But Tifa gestured that she wanted Aerith. Ask and ye shall receive. It's Aerith and Tifa, the former friends. And they're duking it out in the middle of that squared circle. Spinning heel kick from Aerith. Aerith, the VWF champion, with a chin breaker. Aerith, Irish whip. Luthes press, fist and fire. Aerith now back on the top. Nails the Swanton bomb. And that is death from above right there. And Aerith with control. Signaled to the fans. And catch a twist of fate. Got it. That'll do it. That'll do it, but no. No, Aerith motioned for Tifa to get back up. Tifa did that. And now she's in the buckle. Devastating clothesline from the champ. Al-Qaeda getting frustrated in the corner. Needing Tifa to make that tag. But it looks like it may never happen. Tifa with a kip up. She's not done. Nails the flying forearm with another kip up. And hot tag is made to Abdallah. Abdallah, her first action in over 10 minutes. Clearing out Lufisto. The VWF champion's in trouble. WMD. Aerith's out. One, two, and it's over. Oh my, a gallant effort. A heroic and gutsy effort on the part of Aerith Gainsborough and Lufisto, but the numbers were just too great for them. You can't expect to go in there 3-on-2 and expect to come out with a win. Oh my, the VWF champion and the Hardcore champion tried their best. They gave it 120% tonight. But ladies and gentlemen, it's a numbers game inside that squared circle, and the three members of Al-Qaeda, led by a very, very, very fresh Abdallah bin Laden, are able to take the victory here tonight. And ladies and gentlemen, you have to wonder, maybe the two champs are in real danger of losing their titles here. Maybe in a lot of trouble. And look at this. Oh my, Aerith knew what was coming, but she took her shot on Abdallah, and I don't blame her. But now, oh my, Lufisto is out on the outside, and look at this. Just Al-Qaeda is a bunch of cowards.